Hello to all, this is Dr. IJR Raghavendra initiating online lecture series on operations research. Today we are going to learn about degeneracy phase of transportation problems. Before starting with the topic, first we will know about two questions. What is degeneracy and what is the purpose of converting degeneracy to non-degeneracy? The answer to the first question is n plus n minus 1 is not equal to a, that is number of rows plus number of columns minus 1 is not equal to number of allocations. It is referred as a degeneracy problem. The second one is, as we know, that a transportation problem may be solved by applying three methods, that is northwest corner rule, LMC, and VAM method. But these methods will give only theoretical solutions. But in the transportation problem, the ultimate goal is to identify optimal solution. For the process of calculating optimal solution from the theoretical solution, we may apply three mode methods, that is MODI method, stepping stone, and results approximation method. For that process, the matrix must be non-degeneracy. Let us see one example. Here the given matrix consists of 4 rows and 4 columns, that is S1, S2, S3, S4, D1, D2, D3, and D4. Solve this problem using VAM. I applied VAM and got this matrix. So once we got this matrix, we can check that whether it is a degeneracy or non-degeneracy. That is n plus n minus 1 is equal to a or not equal to a. So what is the number of rows in our problem is 4, and number of columns is 5, 4 plus 5 minus 1, that is equal to 8, and number of allocations are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 not equal to 7, that is referred to degeneracy. And the total cost of this problem is 1,215. But 1,215 is a feasible solution, it is not an optimal solution. So for the process of identifying optimal solution, the above matrix must be a non-degeneracy form. Non-degeneracy means it must be equal. N plus n minus 1 is equal to a. For that process, we may convert this degeneracy into the non-degeneracy by using of one concept, that is loops. This is very much important concept in the transportation. What is a loop? A loop is an ordered sequence consisting of lines and form a definite shape, that is, shape, rectangles, and shape, step. A loop can be started from unoccupied cell and travels through possible occupied cell. So a loop may be in the form of a shape, a form of rectangle, or a form of a step. So these three forms of loop are accepted, but not accepted is this diagonal type of loops are not accepted. So a loop cannot be a diagonal shape. So let us discuss more about the loops. A loop can be started from unoccupied cell. Suppose, imagine this is an unoccupied cell. I can start the loop like this. So this is referred as a loop. So what I followed is, I am going in the right direction, down, left direction, in upward direction. What you observe is a loop has a starting point. This is the start point, and if you observe the start point itself only the end point. Both are from unoccupied space. Both are unoccupied, and these corners, this is an occupied cell. This is also an occupied cell. This is also an occupied cell. And one more thing is, a starting point must have a positive sign. An alternative sign is minus for the first stop, second stop plus, and this is minus. So that means number of plus signs must be equal to number of minus signs. It is treated as a closed loop, otherwise it is not a loop. Let us see one more example here. Suppose a loop started from here and going in a left direction. So down, like this. So this is the start point, itself only the end point. So this is an occupied cell, this is an occupied cell, and this is also an occupied cell. So you must assign plus and its start point, minus, plus and its limit, minus. And if you see this particular diagram, suppose this is the start point, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. And see, the number of plus must be equal to the number of minus. So let us use this concept for solving the degeneracy into the non-degeneracy. So the matrix we got by using BAM here, first see the particular matrix and study about if loop is possible. So it is referred as a dependent cell. If loop is not possible, that particular cell we have is referred as an independent. So we must concentrate only on unoccupied cell. First we may write down how many unoccupied cells are there. That is S1D2, S1D3, S1D5, S2D1, S2D2, S2D3, S3D1, S3D2, S3D4, S3D5, S4D3, S4D4, S4D5. So these are all the unoccupied cells are there. So from unoccupied cells, what we learned the loop is, a loop can be started from unoccupied cells. So first one S1D2, so this is the unoccupied cell and this is the start point. I am going here, we have to construct a loop. We have three possibilities are there, left, right and down direction. Suppose if I move to the right direction like this, if this is the stop point, why I stop here is this is an occupied cell. I am going to the down direction. Again, this is the stop position because it is not possible. The remaining one unoccupied cells, you may not stop at unoccupied cells. You must stop at occupied cells only. So for this, it is only possible way to go to the right direction. But in the right direction, there is no further movement. That means it is not possible to construct a loop at the right direction of from the unoccupied cell. Let us consider one more thing. Suppose if I go to the left side like this, this is the stop position, and see, yes, there is one more occupied cell is there. This is the second one. Yes, there is one more stop occupied cell, this one, and we may go to like. So see, this is a complete loop is there. So that means we can say that S1D2 is having a loop. So it is possible to construct a loop from S1D2. So it is referred as dependent. S1D2. Next step, S1D3. See, in the S1D3, we have three possibilities are there. This is the right direction. Suppose if I move to the right direction, this is top position. This is stop and this is one. So it is not possible to construct a loop for the right direction. Suppose if I move to the left direction like this, 1, 2, 3, but there is no further movement in this line, so that is not possible for us to construct a loop. And there is one possibility, yes, there is only one possibility, no left and no right possibilities are there. So that means we can say that S1D3 is an independent. That means no loop. Next case, S1D5. S1D5, we have start left direction. See, S1D5 is having a loop. Closing loop is there. So we can set that S1D5 is having dependent cell. Dependent. Next one, S2D1. S2D1. So we have three possibilities are there. So, upward direction, suppose if I move to the upward direction, the right direction, this one, yeah. So that is complete loop is there. So S2D1 is having a loop. So it is dependent cell. So next one, S2D2. Let's check that S2D2 is having a loop or not. So S2D2, right direction, yes, left, down, right. So this is a complete loop is there. So a loop not in the form of square or rectangle. So it is a stepped wise loop is there. So we can set that S2D2 is having a loop. So it is dependent. S2D3. Check for S2D3. So it is possible, go to the right direction, upward, left, down, right side. So not possible. So loop is not possible from S2 to D3. So it is referred as independent set. Independent or no loop. F3 D1. Take one more loop, F3 D1. So we have three possibilities. If I go to this direction, it is not possible to me to construct a loop for this method. It is not correct direction. Suppose if I go to the down direction, there is only one possible way is there, but there is no further movement in the line. So it is not possible. Suppose if I go to the right direction, upward direction, right, down and right, again not possible. So that means we can say that S3 D1 is not having any loop. So it is referred as an independent. F3 D2. Suppose down direction, left, upward direction, right direction, down direction, again right direction. So it is not possible to construct a loop for F3 D2. So next case is F3 D4. So we have two possibilities, either left side or upward direction. Suppose if I move to the left side, it is not possible to me to construct a loop because there is no more occupied cells are there and no more occupied cells upward direction, down direction. So it is not possible. Suppose go to the only one direction, this one. So this direction, left side, down, right, but it is not possible. So loop is not possible for F3, D4. Next one is F3 D5. So we have two possibilities, either left side or right side. Suppose if I move to the left side, yes, left side, upward direction, left direction, down, right, but not possible because there is no occupied cells in this, so no more stops are there. So only one more possibility, go to the left side. So it is not possible to construct a loop for F3 D5. Next one, S4 D4. Sorry, S4 D3. So I have two possibilities, either upward direction, but no more possibilities are there. So go to the left direction. Further left, this is the stop. And upward direction, right side, down and right. Not possible. So loop is not possible for S4 D3. Next case S4 D4. So I have two possibilities, either left side or right direction. Suppose if I move to the left side, yes, this is a stop. And upward direction, right direction, yes. So see, S4 D4 is having a loop. So we can set that it is dependent set. It is dependent. Loop is possible. S4 D5. So again, S4 D5 is having two possibilities, either right side, either upward direction or left side. So I can go to the upward direction, left side, again upward direction, left side, down, right. So loop is possible. So this is a stepwise type of loop is there. So you can say that S4 D5 is having a loop. So it is referred as dependent. So now our process is completed based on the loops. So out of these total loops, forget about the dependent cells. So I'm striking down the dependent cells like this. So there are six dependent cells are there, forget about that, and we need to concentrate only on the independent loop. And see, independent S1 D3, that is 11. Next one is S2 D3 13, S3 D1 9, S3 D2 2, S3 D4 16, S3 D5 0, S4 D3 14. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 unoccupied cells are there. Out of this, identify the lowest number. So what is the lowest number? 0 is the lowest number and which locates at S3 D5. So I am introducing one new letter, that is E. What is E is? What is E? That is called epsilon or dummy. What is epsilon? Epsilon is not a number. It is not a 0, but we can treat it as a 0 for the calculation purpose. So the final form of the table is like this. So 35, 15, 25, 25, 55, E, 65 and 35. Now we can consider whether it is a degeneracy or non-degeneracy. N plus N minus 1 is equal to A or n plus n minus 1 is not equal to 8. So how many number of rows are there? 4 plus 5 minus 1 and number of allocations are 8. That is 8 and 8. That means 8 equal to 8. That is non-degeneracy. So we successfully converted the degeneracy problem into the non-degeneracy. Now we can follow or we can apply some MODI method, stepping stone method or RAM method for optimal solution. I hope all of you understand about the concept. I will upload more videos even on complicated problems in an easy manner. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.